Hi, welcome to my channel Cisco Config. My name is Abdul Basit. I am Cisco CCNA CCNP certified engineer. Today I show you how to connect Cisco router or switch using console cable and PuTTY. I hope so. After watching this video, you know that how and where to connect console cable between laptop and Cisco switch or router. How to download and configure PuTTY in laptop. How to check laptop serial COM port for PuTTY. How to log in Cisco switch or router via PuTTY. And finally, how to change text color, background, font style and size in PuTTY permanently and for session also. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and press bell icon. Here you can see I have two Cisco switch. It's Catalyst 29X series and Catalyst 3550 series. It's 48 port switch. I power on both switches and it's fully booted. This is the console cable that we will use today. It have one end. It's a USB end. You can see here. And the second end is RJ45. The RJ45 end of the console cable will go to the switch console port. Here you can see the we have 2960 switch and it have a two port here in the front. One is the console port, this one, and second one is the management. So we connect RJ45 end of console cable to console port. Here is it. And second end of the console cable, that is a USB end, that will go to connect to my laptop USB port. Here you can see it is connected to my laptop. You can see here Cisco 2960 have a console port in the front, but Cisco 3550 switch don't have console cable in the front. His console port is behind of the switch. I can show you this side here. Now my console cable connected from switch to laptop. To access Cisco router or switch, whatever device you have, we need terminal emulator software like PuTTY. You can download from internet easily. Go to your browser and type PuTTY. Enter. Go to the first link, putty.org. Then you click here. Go a little bit down and you can find here alternative binary file. As per my system, I will download 64-bit PuTTY file. Click here. It will download automatically. When download complete, we will click on this file or you can right click and open. Now my PuTTY is open. You can see here many other options, like for example Telnet or SSH. But in our case, we are not taking remote access. We are configuring locally. So we go to the serial port. So which serial port do we use? To know that, right click on Windows Start. Go to Device Manager here. Or right click on this computer. Go to Properties. And you find Device Manager here also. Click on Device Manager. Here you can see ports, COM and LPD. Open this and you can see USB serial port COM3. So in my case, I'm using COM3. I will go serial and select COM3. Click on open and press enter. So here you can see switch and we successfully enter in our device. You can write enable to enter in privileged mode. Till now in this video, we see how to connect console cable from Cisco switch to our laptop and how to download PuTTY and how to check our COM port and connect to the Cisco switch or Cisco router. Now I show you how to change PuTTY text and background color and change font size in putty. To do that, right click on the top of the putty and go to change setting, then go to colors, select default foreground, modify. So currently our color in white, we can write our words in or our commands in white color. You can change in any color. For example, I select yellow, then click add to custom color. Okay, apply. Now you can see my text color change white to yellow. If I want to change the background of the putty, like I have black background right now, to change the background we have to do right click and go to change setting, go to color. Now we go to default background, modify. So here we have option, so we can select any color or any background. For example, I select red, then go to add to custom and OK and apply. So here you can see my background color also change and my text color also change. Third thing, if we want to change the font size or font style and size both, to do that you again go right click, go to change setting. This time we will go to appearance, go to change. Here we have options, we can change the font. For example, I have a many option here. I can go to terminal, then we have a style, we can select bold or bold oblique, and we have a size, I can put size 15, then click on OK and apply. So here you can see our fonts also change and font size also changed. But this all change only for this session. If you go exit and close this putty software, this all setting are gone. You can log in putty again, go to the serial COM3, as you know my laptop have COM3 port open, and here you can see it's black background and the text color also white and the font also change. If you want to change putty text color and background color and font size and style permanently, then you have to do these steps. First go to setting, change setting, go to color. To change the text color, go to default foreground, click on modify. So here you can select what text color you are looking or what text color you want. For example, I put black, click add to custom and OK, then click on apply. Now my text color is black, but you cannot see. To change background color, right click, go to change setting, again go to colors. This time we go default background and go to modify. So background color I put white, go add to custom and OK and apply. So here you can see my text color and background color are changed. To change the font style or size, just right click on the top, go to change setting, click on appearance, go to change. So here you can change the font style whatever you like. For example, I select this one, you can style also like bold, size also like 20, click on OK. Before clicking on apply, to save it permanently, go to session, click on select default setting, click on save and then apply. So now you can see your putty font, background and size and style changed. You can log into the switch, it will remain same. Even you close the putty, yes, the setting will be saved permanently. Open putty again, put COM3, open, and here is it. So like this you can select any setting in Putty permanently. After watching this video, I hope so, now you know that how and where to connect console cable between laptop and Cisco switch or router, how to download and configure Putty in laptop, how to check laptop serial COM port for Putty, how to log in Cisco switch or router via Putty, and finally how to change text color, background, font style and size in Putty permanently and for session also. I hope you like my videos. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel for more videos.